drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio.
Oh, my God.
This is John on the right and his sister Yoko on the left. And they're what's good in the White House where I live. Anyway, I love the Oh My Goff podcast.
When he said the White House, I was kind of looking around and I'm like,
Me too.
But it's Robbie White, so the White House and John
good one,
and
Robbie.
John and Yoko, adorable names. Imagine all the people. We got a packed show. We have a very, very special guest. Getting up, we got Blake McCoy joining us in the house. He's going to be coming in, and he's terribly frightened.
And he hasn't seen the studio yet, so he's going to be super surprised to see that Tay-Tay took over the joint.
He loves Taylor Swift, and we have decorated. We have decked the place out for him, okay? And but we are still recovering. Yes. That is a rewind back to my past, the past 48 hours of my life. Baby Wren finally had her party.
Oh my gosh, and was she lit or what?
Chin came, Chin and Wren, the grandpa and grandma shark. The birthday song led by Mama Chin. She was not playing around.
Yep.
Yeah, that translation, hurry the up. Bob decided to throw in his own harmony. The entire time, he's like screaming at Adora and then asking me if he can blow out more candles. I'm like, this is not your birthday. Happy birthday, Wren. But
we love you, Wren.
She had a blast.
She did.
And then she opened her gift from you.
Yes. Oh my God.
This was cute.
Oh my. What is that?
Cat.
Cat.
She had a cat.
How cute is this?
Choo-choo.
Yes, choo-choo.
Choo-choo.
Oh, you love it? Oh, you love it?
We have a lot to get to today, as we mentioned,
yes.
Including a very special guest. He is my partner in crime. He is my work hubby,
mm-hmm.
and he has the best name in television news.
I'm Blake McCoy. Right now.
That's my whole world.
Hey, Tay-Tay. Favorite song right here.
Oh, look what I got you.
Stupid games, you win stupid prizes.
I gotta get my bling on too.
You know how to make someone feel right at home. You got a Taylor Swift cutout. You're too much, Angie. This is why you don't sleep,
wait,
Angie.
Are you trying to say I'm extra? Have you seen the cookies?
Oh my God. There's
and I know you like puzzles to relax.
Do I?
So adult color, yes. Adult coloring is really in. So we got your coloring book.
Yeah.
Okay.
So in your free time in between shows. Relax, you know, relieve the stress, color some Tay-Tay.
This is actually amazing.
I know.
You know, I sit next to Angie at work.
Yes.
She's always like frantic, mm-hmm. never has enough time in the day. But this is why you're buying Taylor Swift coloring books and ordering Taylor Swift cutouts.
He gets it now.
We're in the hallway, she's a bad, bad girl.
Hey.
The whole school is rolling fake dice.
Put the beat to it.
Stupid games, you win stupid prizes.
Okay, can I tell you what I like? Can we go deep on this song for a minute?
Yes.
Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince. It takes all of Taylor's imagery from earlier in her career
mm-hmm.
with a more modern outlook on it. So all the high school imagery and stuff from her Fearless album days, now it's they're rolling fake dice. You know, playing games, rolling fake dice
true?
In the hallways.
So, circle.
So, like, Tears on My Guitar is in there, too?
No, Tears on My Guitar is not in there.
Yes.
So nice to be here in the Woo! Flesh.
Feeling 22 and looking like it, too.
I know. Isn't he beautiful?
Oh, my gosh. The cutest.
I tell people I work with Channing Tatum.
I could see that.
I tell them.
Now
I'm like,
just...
I work with Magic Mike, and he's got the moves. He brings it every day. You want to show him
some
moves?
Can you imagine? No. That's an HR violation in the making.
So Balake, as I call him, is we mentioned that he was a little nervous about coming on. I told him about our 2 a.m. FaceTime.
Okay, so this is the best thing about Angie. I know the kids are long asleep. Her husband does not stay up late, so right. He's asleep. So I know if I call Angie at like 1:30 in the morning, she will pick up the FaceTime.
She will, yeah.
And there is always a wig on her head.
She'll be like,
just a second. And then she'll come back, and this Saturday it was a Cher wig. Mm-hmm. I'll share the picture.
Yes.
I took screenshots.
Oh, you took screenshots? Oh, you sneak. We have been working together since July, mm-hmm. I guess. How's that been for you? Be candid.
Keep it 100.
When people ask you how
like
amazing
an acid
I am.
Trip every day. It really is, Angie. But I love it.
Oh my
I have
gosh.
Come to love it.
That might be my new bio line for all social media. I'm like an acid trip every day.
She is. She's a whirlwind of energy, but it's so much fun.
Isn't it?
It's a blast.
Yeah. Sometimes you have to make me focus, but I think it's a good...
I told our boss the other day, I said, I anchor the newscast and I anchor Angie.
That's pretty accurate.
I'm anchoring two things here.
But you do a flawless job at it, Blake.
Well, thank you. And Angie has a lot of strengths. Staying on time, on schedule, like on the teleprompter, reading when you're supposed to. Okay. Those are not strengths of Angie Goff. But Angie is funny and brings the personality and
great
the credibility.
With impromptu, too, you know what I mean?
You know, with talent like this, it has to just, you know, you have to let it fly.
Yeah, it's so true.
Blake likes to come in and he like reads his scripts.
I'm like, Angie, are you going to read your scripts today? She goes, I like to be surprised. She's like, I like to experience it with the viewer.
He knows you so well.
Fox 5 has been really fun for us. I mean, it was a big change for Angie and I.
Is this real life?
And this tells you what kind of place Fox 5 is. The only feedback I've gotten at work is, we just want you to be more you.
Oh.
Just more Blake. We just want more Blake. And I'm like, okay.
If that isn't the best feedback ever, I mean, you've already got Angie and Baby Shark costume behind you. I saw the chest bump thing happening recently.
Yeah.
Y'all got like Destiny's Child playing in the commercial outtakes. I'm like, Angie, this show is lit.
I know,
Angie,
literally.
Do they tell you to be less you?
No. Ready? Every time I get called in and the door is closed, I'm like, what did I do?
What did I do?
You know, because to be honest, in traditional media, that's very typical. Yeah. Usually here, when you've done something wrong or you've stepped over the line or you said something that you shouldn't or you offended somebody. And so it has been a huge gear shift. And Blake and I talk about it a lot. It is different going to a place that actually practices what they preach. Mm. You know, you will hear from a lot of news organizations, be authentic, be real. And then in comes the consultants.
Yes.
You know,
we have to get to the beauty department and God knows how long that's going to take.
And they are going to tell you how to talk, how to banter,
right.
How to create moments, how to dress, how to do your hair. And so, you know, and I talked to my agent about this, you know, when I considered taking the job and I talk about it publicly. It's just, I remember telling him, look, I'm not going back into news if I'm going to be put in a box.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going back. I'm not doing it. Okay.
Would people tell you, management would tell you that your dress was awful or didn't look good on TV?
So before you came about, I was one sitting next to her. And I remember those days where she'd be like, they told me to stop wearing white, but I'm not going to stop wearing white. Like literally, like, yes, they would tell her what to wear.
I have been told that, you know, we need an intervention.
And you become an embarrassment to yourself and everybody else.
My thing is, if they're going to micromanage like that, then they better bring in wardrobe people and give you clothes then.
If you want to stay connected with people, you've got to get the information out, but you also have to want them to stick around.
Mm-hmm. And give it to them in a way that they can relate to.
Yes.
Well, and that has been a big adjustment with Fox 5 because we give our opinions on the air a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Not political opinions or not controversial stories that are happening in the community, but we give our opinions on just random stories
on
throughout
John
the day.
Legend and Kelly Clarkson.
Exactly.
I have one more dream.
It's your body and your choice.
Shut up.
Can you imagine giving that opinion though at any other
No, you guys would be scared to do so.
Yeah, no, I can't.
So when you guys came together, you also launched a brand new show.
Mm-hmm.
So you were able to be yourselves from the
Friends
jump and also, right, create this new brand
Angie,
and vibe.
Angie tried to rename it the first day. So
that's
Angie's only suggestion when we're in the meeting after the first run through. She's like, so how do we feel about the name? And
I need
it's
to
five
order
and four.
angles. Right. What about the name?
It's 5 and 4. It's pretty simple. What about the name? And the news director goes, we're happy with the name. And she goes, what about Friends at 4?
I got chills.
So, and this is what's so great about Angie,
but
though.
But it's genius.
It is genius. And this is why our partnership works so well. I have a news background. I always go back to hard news.
He's like a
Angie
real journalist.
Wants to do a talk show.
Yeah.
So we merge those two things together
and
we get a really fun conversational
guest. If we had two of Blake's, can you imagine how boring that show would be?
Been there, done that. We've already seen enough of that.
And to me, you'd never get to the first commercial break.
It is a perfect combination.
Yeah.
The yin to the yang.
I think it gels. And, you know, sometimes we get on each other's nerves. But, you know, that's
Pisces.
Well, I don't know.
Pisces problems because you're both Pisces.
Well, remember, I get on your nerves.
I kind of made you look like a creep one time on air.
What'd you do?
I don't know. I think that I said that you were like Googling lingerie or something.
Oh, you did say something. It was something curvy. And I'm like, it's not true, first of all.
But it was funny.
It's funny when you make those about yourself. It's not funny when you make them about me.
So for the record, like 3 months ago, he was not Googling lingerie.
It was about Googling lingerie. That's what it was. I'm like, I'm not at my desk Googling lingerie.
And he walked up. He was like, you made me sound like a creep. And I'm like...
So I creep.
Yeah.
Keep it on the down low.
Nobody is supposed to know.
Well, this is a perfect union, and I'm happy to endorse it for sure.
I need to get invited to one of your parties.
Oh my God, seriously, I thought
My friends are obsessed with you, and a lot of them don't live in D.C. because I've lived other places,
so they only know
Angie from my Instagram stories.
Oh my God, I love it.
And they are obsessed with Angie.
I mean, how
and
could you not be?
And mine are obsessed with him. So yeah.
The Blangie tour needs to happen.
It does need to happen. And oh my gosh.
I go, Angie, don't you have kids? Like, that's why I don't invite you on these vacations. You have 3 kids. She goes, oh, I don't see him that much anyway.
They're in school. Listen. They cut me open 3 times. I've given enough.
I have suffered enough.
We have a very special announcement, which isn't even really a big announcement, but I've made it a big announcement. And for this, I feel like I need I need to change. Hold on.
And I'm Magic Mike. You're the one always taking your clothes off.
Oh my gosh, right? And stripping on set.
You should see her when she's putting the microphones on.
Well, you can see it if you follow Blake McCoy DC
on
Instagram.
You look really tan. You look really tan.
He's always catching me, perv, while I'm changing.
What is this? Hallmark and chill. What is the prop budget at this podcast? You guys have so many props.
Here's our big announcement. Hit it, Rob.
Yeah.
Come on.
Can you feel it, baby?
Let's see, Rob.
Oh, Magic Mike in the house now. Yes.
I got my little
boy. We are getting Hallmarkies. Blake and I are very excited about the countdown to Christmas.
Yes.
And the Hallmark movies. And we were excited about this before even Halloween. And we have decided that we are going to live IG.
Yeah, we're going to do a live Instagram story, our review of the Hallmark movie. We've had a really hard time picking which one to do. Mostly because they all look exactly the same.
We can't do this without like a nice red truck. We have our popcorn bowl.
I cannot believe you have that.
Blanche's Hallmark movie night.
Now, a real Hallmark movie would have so much fake snow, we would be buried in here.
Well, that's what Adam's going to do in post-production.
Because we're going to be rolling cookies.
Oh my gosh, even though she can't cook. But she can bake.
I wanted to present to you your own luxury cloak. No, unless you're making me some cookies. So this is a Snuggie. Do you like it?
It's
a Christmas Snuggie. It's like a blanket.
Oh,
that
you're supposed to wear it the other way then, right? Because the whole thing's supposed to be in the front of you?
I have no idea.
Oh my God.
You really should follow Blake McCoy DC on Instagram because every day is a story with us. And he always starts off like this.
It's me looking at the camera, and then I do a reveal to Angie, and God knows what happens.
What's going to get caught, right? Yeah. I remember that one moment. Was your dress falling down or something like
that? Always. He gets me my most vulnerable moments. this weekend, we could do Right Before Christmas, Right, W-R-I-T-E,
okay.
Christmas at Graceland, or the next weekend, there's Christmas Under the Stars. Oh, Rob voted for Christmas at Graceland. And then there's also Cherished Memories, A Gift to Remember.
Boring.
Christmas Under the Stars, is that?
Yeah, so that's Thanksgiving weekend. Are you in town?
Yeah.
Okay, so am I.
This whole thing started with me being like, hey, should we just have a movie night? And then this is where Angie's mind has taken it.
She's like, hell yeah, and we're going to brand it too.
That's what we're going to do. Christmas Under the Stars, and you're all invited.
Can we see the couple? Are they believable?
I mean, could the picture get any cornier?
Oh, I'm into that.
But they all look the same.
You want it to be corny.
No, like, you do. Yeah. It's Hallmark.
I mean, poinsettias everywhere. And
I mean, a full moon just happened. It's perfect. Christmas Under the Stars.
And Balake, I know because... because I'm going to have to field the calls. Are you single?
Ready I am single.
You know what phone number to hit.
Yep, me. You have to go through me, okay?
Give everyone your
because
cell phone
I've
number.
I've seen some of the on your IG. Stop. Don't send that stuff, okay? We don't like to see it. I don't like to see it. I sit right next to him. I don't like to
for
see
anyone.
It.
Okay, tell me about DC living. Are you loving DC life?
I am. I just bought a condo, so I'm so excited. I've rented my whole life because I've, you know, moved around a lot in the TV world, climbing the ladder, and finally setting down roots.
I just have one question. Are you going to have a picture of me in it?
That one. I want that one in there.
I got one for you.
That's not you.
Yes, it is.
In what decade? That's your, is that your first TV job headshot?
No.
That's here?
Oh, that looks horrible.
Oh my goodness. That hair, the pearls.
It's even better. Yeah, that was her first. Yeah, that was like 9 years ago, right?
This is consultant driven. This is what they do to you.
I was going to say, if you want to know the difference between Fox 5 and every other TV station.
Literally.
This is Fox 5.
Yeah.
That is every TV station.
I know. Isn't it crazy?
And you know what?
You should feel blessed.
Did you just take that off the wall when you stopped working there?
Yeah.
No.
Because that was probably in a hallway somewhere.
This is one of the first ones. They wouldn't give me the most recent
one. The second one's even, I mean, that's when the haircut was cute, but they made you cut it
too short. I think they were worried I would do something to it, so they did not give it to me.
For all things Blake.
All things Blake, go to Blake McCoy DC on the Twitter, the Facebook, and
the Instagram.
The Instagram, right?
Instagram's the most fun,
we love the stories.
Where it's at.
And you can always catch us at 4 p.m. Eastern. It's 1 hour of your life you'll never get back.
But it's worth it.
Newscast, but we guarantee you will have a smile on your face.
Yes, and we have a great time. And if you don't live in the D.C. area, then you can always just go to fox5dc.com/live or watch it via the app, and you can hang with us. Don't you dare start disrobing!
I just had this moment where I thought to myself, why am I still wearing all this stuff? I thought it was a cute polo shirt. I thought I looked good in it.
Oh, yes. Okay, so if there's one thing Blake can offer, go ahead, flex. Flex.
I'm not flexing.
Yes, you were made to. You were born to flex.
Hit him with the flex. Hit him with the flex.
Come on. There we go.
Blake McCoy, everybody. All right, cheers. It's you and me. There's nothing
like this. This Americana and the. Well, that wasn't as scary as I thought it was.
It's now time for
Awakening.
I don't think I really need to introduce this next video. In fact, let's just get to it. What you're looking at here, and for those of you just listening to us, is we have a car that was stopped at a light and stopped his car in the middle of the crosswalk while everybody else is behind the crosswalk. Then the light turns green and all the cars get to go, but one of the pedestrians decided to turn the tables.
And boy, do they turn.
Stands right in front of the car, and the car has nowhere to go. This happens all the time, and rarely do you see. You see people walking by being like, what are you doing? And they yell at you.
Right.
But this person, you know, actions speak louder than words.
So true.
And I think that even though I don't recommend this because it is kind of dangerous, you should never stand in front of a car because you just don't know how people might react, you know, the road rage that might exist out there and so forth. Whoever you are, you Mr. Amen. Who said, I'm not going to take this anymore. Don't park in the crosswalk. Standing up for pedestrians worldwide.
Yes. Shout out to you.
I do that crime, we'll never do it again.
Shout out to Block A for stopping by. Yes. You know, he handled it like a pro.
I know. He was nervous for no reason.
Oh my gosh.
And boy, did he wore that sash.
Oh, did he?
He wore that sash. So thank you, Balake, yes, for coming by. I'm going to try to get a hold of Ken Jung. I'm still trying to get a hold of him because I am determined to get him on the show.
Yes.
I told Fox that I want to cover the finale of The Masked Singer, but I will only go if I can go as Ken Jung.
Oh, my God.
And do all my live reports as Ken Jung.
It's going to happen. Speaking it into the existence now.
They didn't oppose it. Coming up, we are still celebrating the holidays.
Yes.
But we have a lot to get to, and we know that we love food, so we're going to have hopefully a special treat for you come next week.
And looking forward to having another special guest join us. You know, it's the time of year where people reflect ahead of the new year. Not only do we want to give to others, but give back to ourselves. So Cyrene Lovett will be joining the show as well. Mm-hmm. Looking forward to Bravo's former reality star coming to the OMG studio.
Next week, don't let me forget, I want to talk about a trampoline.
Oh, Lord.
I came home and there's a trampoline in the house. And it was not for my kids.
I was a witness.
And I'm going to leave it at that, Robert. Hi. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Actually, it's a really cold day in the neighborhood. Someone who knows more about being kind than Mr. Rogers himself. This is really super cute. Fred Rogers once said, imagine what our real neighborhoods would be like if each of us offered, as a matter of course, just a kind word to another person. So I'm gonna start with myself. You matter. Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, which is the new movie that's coming out with Tom Hanks. Loved him since Splash. Can you see that? The signature red sweater. I don't know if you noticed, the box was already open. Bob did come up to me before he left for school and he's like, what's that red box? There's toys in it.
Just so you know, that was all initiated by your daughter.
Ooh, what is this? Sweater weather.
Looks like a beer koozie to me.
Beautiful day in the neighborhood. But we know Wren's really into purses. Mr. Rogers' tote. Be kind. You guys smell a Christmas picture coming up. You know, you are like my Mr. Rogers. You're so welcoming every day.
Your toolbox.
We'll read this. Oh my God, no, stop. Celebration of America's most beloved children's show. This is a visual history. I mean, I used to watch this all the time. There's scripts. It just really shows you why this was a place where anything could happen. World Kindness Day, be kind.